Good evening and welcome to the College Church of Seventh-day Adventists and the Vesper program here by the Dr. Roy Ball Hazen and family and company to present this evening's Vesper program. We're glad they're here and we're glad you're here and we're praying that you will get a blessing. Shall we pray? Father God, we thank you for sharing this Sabbath day with us. And we pray that you would bless the participants in this program. Thank you for loving us and that you hear our prayers in Jesus' name. Amen. The famous Dr. Maria Roy Ball Hazen.
Good evening, AC alumni and friends and guests and people who are watching us. It gives me great pleasure and a lot of anxiety to present to you this evening an interpretation of the betrayal of Jesus by Judas, which was painted in the 1300s by a painter, a Renaissance, pre-Renaissance painter, Giotto. And he did a fresco in Florence. And the reason that I have chosen Giotto, well, because we are beginning in the Passover week, and the events, and a lot of people are cued in to what happened to Jesus and then to celebrate his resurrection. And we are too at the AUC Art Department. We are focusing on those events. And in fact, on your seats, there's a little flyer about a little movie. But that's not the reason I have always loved Giotto. The reason I love Giotto is because he was the first painter that you would have thought he had read the book Desire of Ages. Well, he didn't, because it wasn't written. But he painted the whole life cycle of Jesus in a series of panels in the Scrovegni Chapel in Florence, Italy. And he was the first man that decided to focus on the life of Jesus, his acts, and the outcomes of his acts. And during that time, everybody was focusing on the Virgin Mary as Queen Mother of Heaven and Earth. And Giotto seemed to want to set the record straight about Jesus. While the fresco was painted with, on wet plaster walls, we are going to be using chalk pastels because we can get things done quickly, and we're using Mai Tian's paper. But I'm sure that Giotto must have had a vision. If you read the story of Jesus' events in the book Desire of Ages by Ellen White, and then go to your computers and just look up Giotto, G-I-T-T-O, and look at all of the panels that he painted, you could see that those two, the writer Ellen White and Giotto, must have somehow had the same vision, because there's a lot of extra details besides what the four Gospels give us. So I can't figure it out any other way than that they must have seen something. In addition, we love music, and we love Francisco Fernandez. And Francisco Fernandez is going to be giving us a concert because God is an artist and God is a musician. And Francisco Fernandez is coming over to the piano. He is a senior music major. And he will be playing tonight Sonata in F Major by Mozart, the second movement. After that, he will play Fantasia in C minor, again by Mozart. Third, he's going to play Concerto in A minor, the second movement, Waldenstein, by Evard Grieg. He's going to play the second and the third movement. I'm sorry, that really is by Beethoven. He's going to play Etude Opus 25, number 11 in A minor by Chopin. Toccata by Cacciatore, and then finally Sonata in number 3, movement number 1 by Federico Ibarra. coming up to paint, coming up on the left panel will be Wayne Hazen. And then in the middle panel will be our son, Harper Hazen. I will be on the right. And I just want to bring to your attention that tomorrow at 11, you will be having a chance to come and see the stage set. And we're going to be using it. Somebody had the idea as they were helping to bring the hay and the dirt that if they could just hear somebody speak like they did back in those days in Jerusalem. So we arranged that for you. And Earl Kirchberg will be there delivering a message as Cleopas, celebrating the first anniversary of his walk with Jesus to Emmaus. And the title of his presentation is going to be, Didn't Our Hearts Burn Within Us? How did we miss it? So he's going to be dressed up, and you will be able to be there and hear him as he might have done it in that time. So thank you very much, and we will now proceed to interpret Giotto's Betrayal of Jesus by Judas.
Thank you. Thank you.
Amen. They're going to teach me that when I get to heaven, how I can do that. Shall we pray? Jesus, even so come, I would pray. We pray for the Timus and family, and we pray for everybody here and those that are not here, that as we begin this new week that we will see Jesus and that we will do things in a way that uplift and glorify you. We thank you that you love us and that you hear our prayers, and ultimately one day we can go home and live forever with you. May this be our prayer. In Jesus' name I pray. Amen.